This is where it all begins. The leap of faith. The first step to the journey. Towards the unknown. The challenging. The daunting. But when we're together, hand in hand, the journey becomes exciting. We're partners, you and I, together, facing your fears, pursuing your passion, breaking boundaries, building your future, overcoming challenges, celebrating every achievement. When we're together, we're unstoppable. When we're together, anything is possible. At BTN, we know the power of partnership. A good partner works with you intimately. A good partner knows what you need. A good partner always has your back. A partner for starting your dream family, building your dream home, realizing the dream. It takes courage to begin, but it takes encouragement to keep on going. So go on, dream big. We're with you every step of the way. You have a partner in BTN.
Definitely a playoff atmosphere in this building, and the number four seed, the BTN CLS Knights, hosting the number five seed Saigon Heat here at the Gorket the Giant Gymnasium here in Surabaya. Season 9 playoffs of the ASEAN Basketball League continue to rise to greatness. My name is Noel Zarate, alongside Marco Benitez. And Marco, if there was any indication of things to come in the playoffs, it was yesterday when San Miguel Ala Pilipinas, the defending champions, got tripped up by Hong Kong Eastern at home. A stark reminder that anything can happen here in the 2019 playoffs of the ASEAN Basketball League.
You know, that is correct, Noel, and it does not get more evenly matched than this series as the number four team versus the number five team. Both these teams have split their season series, each winning in the other's home court. So the winning margin, average winning margin between the CLS Knights and the Saigon Heat has been 1.5 points per game. So that is how close it has been. As we take a look at the playoff format, 1 versus 8, we are looking at number 4 versus number 5. And the other series, Eastern, getting that first win against San Miguel Ala Pilipinas. And of course, the Singapore Slingers will be battling the Macau Black Bears actually every series is so exciting to watch out for.
It's just the best of three. Two wins, you get into the semifinals. But here are the keys to the game right now, Marco, for the BTN CLS Knight.
Of course, playoff time, you have to execute. You cannot afford to make mistakes. Don't turn over the basketball. Rebounding is going to be key, especially with a guy like Darrell Watkins in the middle, and run their offense. We know they love to control the tempo, especially here at home. They have to dictate the tempo, get out in transition, get baskets in transition. Talking about the BTN CLS Knights.
Yeah, the BTN CLS Knights welcoming back their coach right here at home. Brian Rousen was not around when these two teams met. It was probably one of the best games, if not the best game of the season, when these two teams locked horns here just a few weeks ago.
That's the one. We're going down to the last second. These BTN CLS Knights actually were down by 11 points in the last 2 minutes, but back-to-back triples from Wong Wei Long, bringing them back from the dead. And of course, Doug Herring winning that duel against Trayvon Hughes, hitting that winning back shot to seal the win for them.
Now I was talking to Coach Coco Nugro, assistant coach for the BTN CLS Knights, and he calls his Knights one of the luckiest teams in the league so far, because not only did they escape with that victory against Saigon, but they also tripped up Hong Kong Eastern in their final game of the regular season on the road, one of the hardest places to win, the Soundbank Stadium.
And they have been a big revelation this season after starting the season at 2-7 and then rattling off several wins and then finishing the season strong with a 6-1 in their last 7 games. So that's how strong the BTN CLS Knights have been, especially here at home.
What a turnaround it has been as well for the Saigon Heat, the last team to qualify for the playoffs last season. Now the number 5 seed, they are being introduced right now. So we send it over to courtside.
Thank you. Kamboja.
And this is our national anthem, Indonesia Raya.
Indonesia versus Saigon. The playoff begin.
And so there, the national anthem of the Indonesians being heard here once again as we take a look at the starting lineup. Pretty much the same for the Saigon Heat here, Marco.
Well, usual starters here for Coach Kyle Julius. Justin Young, of course, will be integral to them, especially on the defensive end of the floor. Same starters as well for the Knights. As we all know, they're one of the top starting five here in the league. In the last meeting, there was actually 0 bench points for them, but their five starters all scoring in double figures. So that is how potent that starting lineup is for Coach Brian Rossum.
What needs to change now for the Saigon Heat to be able to get this win on the road and replicate what the Hong Kong Eastern squad did against San Miguel Ala Pilipinas? We take a look at our officials. Of course, our lead official, Vigor Boron, is from the Philippines, and official from Thailand, as well as an official from India. What needs to change here for Kyle Julius?
Well, for Kyle Julius and the rest of the Saigon Heat, primary thing here for them is to defend the perimeter. The CLS Knights, one of the best three-point shooting teams. They're actually tied for first at 37%. They're third in the league in terms of number of makes per game, at about 9 makes per game. So they have to defend that. Everybody knows how comfortable they are shooting it here in Gorkurta Jaya. And of course, they cannot allow the Knights to dictate tempo here at home. That means they cannot commit that many turnovers, because we all know the CLS Knights thrive on those live ball turnovers, converting them into baskets on the other end. And they cannot allow the Knights to really feed off the energy of this crowd. In terms of energy, we all know this is one of the most passionate crowds we have
Yes.
here in the ABL.
And they have their very own Knight as well. Talk about shooting well in this building. The BTN CLS Knights actually set a league record, making 22 threes in this building. And if that wasn't enough, they followed it up in their next game with 18 threes. So 40 three-pointers in 2 games. A record in the league set by the BTN CLS Knights. One of the catalysts, of course, of that 7-game winning streak that they had to make them the number 4 seed coming into the playoffs right now. And the Saigon Heat, it's interesting. Maxi Esho had a campaign with the Saigon Heat last season. He must know this team inside and out. However, it is a different team for Saigon, but we can't help but say revenge game every time these two teams meet.
Oh, yes, that's definitely correct. As of course, you know, Maxi Esho has been a front runner, I believe, for MVP, and he has found a home here in the BTN CLS Knights. But of course, the Saigon Heat want to change things. They want to be the ones to upset a higher seeded team. Very capable. They're also very capable of that, as we've seen this season. Of course, for the Saigon Heat, number one, or one of the keys for them as well, is to defend Maxi Esho. This
Yes.
guy averages about 20 points per game against the Saigon Heat. And another one who really steps up against the Saigon Heat is Daryl Watkins. averages at 14 points per game, but against the Saigon Heat, he's averaging close to 20 points per game, and that is because the interior of the Heat is not as strong as opposed to the other teams, as of course we all know Kyle Barone likes to play from the outside. So if they can neutralize that on Watkins to begin this ball game, the Heat will be on good footing.
Now there's Maxi Escher right now. Didn't really have a good game in that nail-biter of a win here they had the last time, but Tran had an excellent game. It's going to be interesting how he matches up with Wong Wei Long, the veteran, and we haven't even spoken about Brandon Jawato, who was probably the best performer for the BTN CLS Knights in their last outing. Nice to see Brian Rousen back on the bench, but he was nervous. We saw him in the hotel earlier. He was trying to be as loose as possible, but he is nervous. We all saw what happened to San Miguel a la Pilipinas yesterday. Will the same fate befall the CLS Knights? If so, it'll be a roller coaster playoffs here in the first round.
Well, this is the first time that the Saigon Heat are entering the playoffs as not as the last seeded team in the playoffs. So big expectation for them. And, you know, especially in the playoffs, what is going to be crucial is which team can settle down first and get into their system, as execution will be key here. We all know Doug Herring, really one of the guys that have turned around this season for the BTN CLS Knights, and he's really the focal point of the offense for them.
Doug Herring attacks immediately. Nobody's stopping him. And Herring getting the first 2 points of the game. We have a sellout here at the Gorkirtachaya Gymnasium. There was a line forming about 2 hours before the game when we arrived. And this crowd is in here already. However, Kyle Barone able to get the first step, and he will tip it in himself, tied at two.
Yeah, that's a nice interior pass there by Trevon Hughes. And that's going to be one of their main weapons, that two-man game. As Trevon Hughes, one of the guys that averages about 6 assists per ball game, really good at finding his open teammates.
There's Doug Herring looking for an open teammate right now. Wong Wei Long, one of the heroes the last time these two teams met, taking it strong. Good defense that time by Tran, but Wong, the veteran, getting it back. Brandon Jawato putting it on the floor. Drop pass inside to Terrell Watkins. Lost the handle. It's Saigon basketball.
Chris Durker will also be an X factor for them, because many times he will be the one matched up against Daryl Watkins, especially on the switches. So he has to be able to put a body on Daryl Watkins, prevent him from getting those offensive rebounds.
I was trying to talk to Kyle Barone before the game, but everybody was so laser focused here for the Saigon Heat that he said very few words, but he did say that he would stay aggressive coming into this matchup. He had a good start the last time these two teams met, but he has to sustain that start, sort of faded in the fourth period. Boy, this crowd is already getting on the nerves of the Heat. And we barely got 1 minute gone in the first quarter.
But I like what the Saigon Heat did on that possession, trying to attack the interior. You cannot fall in love with that outside shot here, especially in Gorkirtachaya.
Doug Herring did mention about free throws being a factor in their last win. And the floor is also going to be a factor here. And it's not raining outside as it was the last time when they were feverishly trying to dry up the floor. But again, the free throws, BTN CLS Knights actually missed 5 key free throws down the stretch. That is a good start for Brandon Jawato. I'll take that for Doug Herring, getting the first 5 points for the BTN CLS Knights.
Remember, Herring can really light it up from the outside. Average about 28% from the 3-point line, but especially good when it matters the most.
Esho pulling up from 17, that is good. CLS Knights off to a hot start on offense.
And that is what you don't want if you're the Saigon Heat. You don't want to get the crowd going this early into the game. Another turnover here for the Heat.
Kyle Julius wanting to settle the troops down. And with 8-11 remaining in the very first quarter, the Saigon Heat will use their first timeout. It is 7-deuce for the BTN CLS Knights. Back at us here at the Gorkirtachaya Gymnasium in Surabaya, Indonesia. The home team off to a hot start, 7-2 in favor of the BTN CLS Knights against the Saigon Heat. Game one of the quarterfinals, best of three affair. My name is Noel Zanate alongside Marco Benitez. And this is just the second game of the playoffs. We do have two more games opening tomorrow. A couple of game ones as Wong Wei Long tries to attack Maxi Escho from deep. What a start for the BTN CLS Knights.
Yeah, the Heat are going to have to adjust on defense. That time, they tried to play over that ball screen for Wong Wei Long. Wong Wei Long so good at attacking the defense, drawing the defense in, and then a quick extra pass there. Triple this early for the BTN CLS Knights.
We did mention the other series is going to be the Mono Vampire visiting the number one seed, the Formosa Dreamers. A little bit of a problem inside for Durker. And they will call a foul. against the BTN CLS Knights. The other matchup, of course, featuring the Singapore Slingers and the Macau Black Bears. That is also an interesting one as we see this again, Marco.
That's great interior defense there by the Knights. Three guys against Chris Durker, and you already get the sense that the intensity is quickly or is obviously on the side of the home squad.
Well, at least this early, let's see if it can be diffused by the Saigon Heat.
The mob guys.
Yeah, they're
already
busy
working
already.
Hard this early.
Still kind of early. In fact, 7:29 remaining in the first. Only one to shoot, and it's thrown away. Brandon Joano with a steal.
That's a careless pass there by Tran. Two turnovers already with still 7:23 remaining in the first.
And again, the nerves might start to get become a factor in this game. Here's Wong Wei Long. He's been there before. He's been in the finals of the ASEAN Basketball League when he was still with the Singapore Slingers. A heads-up play that time for Doug Herring. He was going to run out of space.
And you like
keep it.
You like the attitude of Wong Wei Long, not setting for outside shots, just looking for ways to get to penetrate the defense, force the defense to be sucked inside the paint.
Juwato on the inbound. They got five to shoot. Daryl Watkins turned back that time by Hamilton. And you are right, Marco. He will be the number one rim protector for the Heat. And it's turned over. Another one coming from Tran. His third turnover. And this is going to lead. Oh, it was supposed to be an easy basket for Brandon Juwato. And the Heat get lucky.
That's a lucky break there for the Saigon Heat. There's another live ball turnover. Almost an automatic 2 points. So dodging a bullet there are the Heat. But they're still down by 8 points.
They need to look for that spark on offense. It's only Kyle Barone who's had a basket here. Nothing yet from Trayvon Hughes. And here's the post up again. Barone. It's going to be called. He's going to be called for steps.
And you like the matchup with Maxi Esho. You see the versatility there of Esho, able to defend the post against Kyle Barone. That allows Daryl Watkins to preserve himself from foul trouble because Hamilton not really the primary option on offense.
Joato doing some point forward chores. Here's Maxi Esho hit a three earlier. Hits another one. This time contested by Turker. And Maxi Esho trying to make up for a lackluster performance, at least at his standards, in their last game.
42% from downtown is Maxi Esho. And that is why he's one of the contenders for MVP, in my opinion.
Hamilton getting aggressive, and he will earn a trip to the free throw line. Doug Herring takes exception to the call.
Good recognition there by D'Angelo Hamilton. Saw the mismatch, did not pass the ball away from his from himself. Instead, takes it strong to the basket, draws the foul against Doug Herring.
So D'Angelo Hamilton, who came in as a late replacement this season for Murphy Bernatowski, was one of the league leaders in points. And Coach Kyle Julius, when I had a chat with him last time, saying, well, they're not going to give him free throws. He brings a different dimension to the team. Definitely not in terms of offense, but being a rim protector and being an inside presence. However, Daryl Watkins strips him, just can't control the ball. 10 to shoot now for Saigon.
Talk about rim protection. That's great timing there on the part of Daryl Watkins. But talk about the CLS Knights. 8 of their 13 points here in the first quarter coming from Maxi Esho. So he is really locked in.
The former Heat trying to douse fire against his former team. Hamilton thinking about it, gets the baseline, and he will slam it down.
And there's no reason there for Daryl Watkins to come out hard on D'Angelo Hamilton because he's not really a threat from outside. So better to sag off and give him that outside shot.
Drive now by Herring. They get it out. Esho, 3 for 3 from deep.
And again, that time forced by that top ball screen, open lane for Doug Herring. No choice there for Kyle Barone but to pick up the penetration and leaving Maxi Esho wide open from the corner.
Well, Maxi Esho is really on a mission right now against his former team. Barone bothered, no whistle. And here comes Wong Wei Long. Wong Wei Long matching up against Tran. Gets the first step. Wong Wei Long aggressive. When was the last time you saw Wong Wei Long take it strong that way?
You know, that's the second time Wong Wei Long has opted to attack using the baseline instead of calling for a ball screen. They're refusing the ball screen, quick crossover, and then takes it to the body of Corey Celia.
Yeah, that is Corey Celia, who did come in to replace Tran after Tran picked up three turnovers. So Wong Wei Long, former local MVP of this league, at the free throw line. Remember in their last game, down 11, Wong Wei Long hit 2 3-pointers in the final minute of the game. and allowed the drama to unfold where the BTN CLS Knights came from behind to take it.
He had 14 points in that game, and so far, the Knights have caught the heat flat-footed here in Gorkur Tejaya.
Now Julius has already used one timeout. Hardly any response from his squad right now. Barone getting it over to Trayvon Hughes. Defense still locked on Hughes. Hughes forced it to a difficult shot. Nobody there to box out Kyle Barone.
That's one of the few times that the Heat are, the Knights rather, were not able to secure the defensive rebound. But you see how focused they are on that penetration from Trayvon Hughes.
Uh-oh. Long way long, and the only guy to stop him is a seven-footer in Kyle Barone. There's Corey Celia, had a big game as well in their last outing here. D'Angelo Hamilton getting it out. Nice fake by Barone. Barone still looking for the contact. None was called, and here comes Joato. Brandon has it poked away from behind. And what an effort that time. Is that Hamilton who's flying into the stands?
Well, Hamilton sacrificing his body there. Goes out the baseline. But the referees are allowing the players to play. And that is what you mean, what you mean when you talk about playoff basketball.
Now we got two senior officials here. And Ricord Buaron from the Philippines, the crew chief. And Atapong Chontapa from Thailand. And the baseline inbound now coming from Brandon Joato. Lots of time here for the BTN CLS Knights. Herring being patient. Watkins from 16, off the glass, top of the key, how about that?
And that's a bonus there if you're Coach Brian Rosen. You expect Dan Watkins to really take it inside, but whenever he can hit that mid-range jumper, you're gonna take it.
Yeah, called back on a Saturday. It is open here in Indonesia. Barone, single coverage being given by Daryl Watkins. Corey Celia momentarily open, hesitates on the shot, now penetrates and scores.
Whenever you can get points off of your bench, if you're Coach Kyle Julius, that's going to be a big bonus for you. Trying to get offense as the rest of the starters have not been able to respond, but Brandon Joato is locked in.
My goodness, that was a contested three, perhaps the third contested three that the Knights have converted on.
I remember Joato showing us the range in that game against the Hong Kong Eastern, had 25 points in that game, so he has that in his arsenal.
Chris Durker taking it strong against Maxi Esho, able to draw the foul. 23-8. What a start by the BTN CLS Knights.
I know the past two wins of the Knights against the Heat have been by an average of 1.5 points. So you see how big of a turnaround this is. 15-point advantage so far for the home squad.
Durker makes good on his first free throw. So 23-9 here, Marco. It's a very, very flat start. I can't say if it's a flat start for the Heat, or maybe we should just give credit to the defense of the Knights.
It's actually just a, you could say this is a really a playoff start for the BTN CLS Knights. They're really, they've leveled up on both ends of the floor, defensively and offensively.
Watkins driving, getting the first step, but Barone is able to catch up and block it. Here comes Trayvon Hughes. Hughes going the other way right now. Corey Celia for three. Good!
That's five quick points from Corey Celia. He's been the X factor so far.
Right.
Five of the 12 of the Heat have come from the bench.
Corey Celia actually did play pretty well in relief of Tran in their last game. Hit some big shots down the stretch as well. Esho! That's his first miss from deep, but Watkins is there. Great strip coming from Hughes, and here come the Heat.
Lucky break there on the part of Justin Young.
Yeah, spin it around once again. This is a deep one. Trayvon Hughes, not a good shot that time, Marco.
Probably not the shot you wanted, down by 11 points. And you're going to try to look for get high percentage shots and not those hurry shots early in the shot clock.
Isolation right now. Herring being watched and being fouled at the same time.
And Douglas Herring, one of those old-fashioned type of point guards, will not really overwhelm you with the scoring, but recognizes those mismatches and has a lot of confidence in his post game. That time, taking on the bigger Justin Young in the post.
I've had long conversations with Doug Herring. When you talk to him, Marco, you get the impression that he could be a future coach one day. The way he breaks down games, and he's still a player.
Well, whenever they the BTN CLSIs have played in a lot of close matches, and they've relied heavily on the execution and the decision-making of Doug Herring, and he has really proven himself time and time again.
The bench coming in, and no goaltend that time. Hamilton swatted that off the board, and the Knights get it back, though. Doug Herring now leading the break. Herring going cross-court. Maxi Esho all day. Back-to-back misses for Esho after hitting his first three.
And Trayvon Hughes has to settle his troops down. They've got to execute on this possession.
Barone giving a lot of space to shoot. How about this one from Chris Durker? And that goes out of bounds.
And again, not exactly the type of shot you wanted. Down by 11 points. There's been two or three possessions where you've not been able to score. So you probably would have wanted something in the post or off a ball screen between Trayvon Hughes and Kyle Barone.
This 23-12 lead actually hasn't moved in a while. Let's see if it can be moved, and Doug Herring does another three-pointer for the BTN CLS Knights.
That's what hurts you, a low percentage shot on one end, and then Doug Herring hits a triple on their end of the floor.
Lead is up to 14, 26-12. Hamilton carving space, and it looks like Maxi Escher's even going to get a flopping warning.
Yep, that's a good non-call there on the part of the referee, as Maxi Escher really tried to sell that one.
That's what Kyle Julius is asking for, a flopping warning. So the next time Maxi Escher does that, he could be assessed for a technical foul. And of course, for the BTN CLS Knights, they have gone to their bench already right now. Two national team players on the floor, Firman Nugroho, along with the shooter, Sandy Kurniawan, back on the floor.
And that's how important the bench is here for the Knights, because Nugroho is going to relieve Daryl Watkins. And every time you can get Watkins rest on the bench, that's so important for Coach Brian Rosen, because that allows him to be more fresh, especially in the end game.
Herring taking his time bringing this down. Herring evading two defenders. Nugroho gets it back. Doug Herring on a bounce pass to Firman Nugroho.
And every time Nugroho can get points inside the paint, that's an even bigger bonus for the Knights.
Three-pointer on its way. Nothing there for Kyle Barone. Boy, Hughes kept that one alive. Moving around, Durker, Hughes now for three. And still nothing for Trayvon Hughes in this game, Marco.
That's back-to-back three-point shots that the Heat have attempted without trying to execute their offense.
Final 8 seconds of the first. And here's Herring. Three-pointer good again!
And how hot have the BTN CLS Knights been in this first quarter? In particular, Doug Herring lighting it up from the field.
17-point lead for the BTN CLS Knights after the first 10 minutes of action against the Saigon Heat. 31-14, second quarter, when we return.
Kenalin, Velas, sahabatmu dalam setiap transaksi falas. Traveling kini tak perlu repot tukar uang ke money changer. Uang saku kuliah kamu di luar negeri tak lagi terpotong ini itu. Kamu bisa mulai tabungan kamu tanpa khawatir kurs naik turun. Dan dengan kurs kompetitif, bisnis kamu akan selalu mendapat nilai tukar terbaik. Nikmati dunia tanpa batas bersama Velas.
Lapar, makan nih jangan mikir. Nih, piknik, gak bikin duduk.
Fit me, makan mie, jangan mikir.
Ketika keadaan tak sesuai harapan.
Stop! Jangan banyak drama. Kenalin, Velas. Sahabatmu dalam setiap transaksi falas. Uang saku kuliah kamu di luar negeri tak lagi terpotong ini itu. Nikmati dunia tanpa batas bersama Velas. Tanpa provisi, tanpa drama.
It has been hot shooting coupled with great defense for the BTN CLS Knights to enable them to take a 17-point lead into the second quarter, 31-14. Noel Zarate is still alongside Marco Benitez, witnessing the fireworks here at the Gorkerta Jaya Gymnasium in Surabaya, Indonesia.
At the start of the game, we talked about defending the perimeter as one of the keys for the Saigon Heat. So far, they have done a poor job of that, as 27 of the 31 points of the Knights have come from the outside. Doug Herring and Max Yesho both with 11 points in the game.
And a miss from the outside for Firman Lugro. Not really his job to be taking some outside shots. Tran back in the game, as is Hamilton.
And the Knights are also 7 of 9 from the three-point line, while the Heat are 1 out of 5.
And the defense inside continues. Lugro getting a piece of that one. Here's Arif Hidayat on the sidestep. Hidayat scores!
And how about the bench of the Knights stepping up? Nugroho in the first quarter right now. Hidayat starting out the second quarter strong.
And the biggest lead of the game for the BTN CLS Knights, 33-14, a reach in on Nugroho.
And you know, that just buys you more time for rest for guys like Brandon Jawato, Darrell Watkins. And that's going to benefit them in the latter portion of the game. And even Wong Wei Long, actually.
That's right, Wong Wei Long not on the floor at this moment. Nugroho trying to force the issue. Here is Tran for three. And another one and done for Saigon.
And as the Heat keep on missing those outside shots, the BTN CLS Knights are going to try to pack it in even more inside the paint.
Here's Arif Hidayat looking for Herring posting up against a smaller Trevon Hughes. Hidayat gets it back, shot clock at 7. Hidayat with a spin, gets it to go, plus the foul!
And that first basket in transition, giving Hidayat the confidence to attack the paint. Nice spin move there, and then kissing it off the glass, plus the foul.
Check that out, actually Febri Otomo, who was in the game already. Febri Otomo, some impact points for him here, Marco.
That's a clear foul there on the part of Corey Celia.
So even the locals contributing now for the BTN CLS Knights. Nugro had a basket earlier, now back-to-back baskets coming from Febri Otomo. That's a perfectly, are they gonna call this a goaltend? Not only is it gonna be a goaltend, it's gonna be a two-point field goal.
D'Angelo Hamilton arguing that, and I think he has a point.
It does.
FIBA rules allow you to interfere with the ball once it touches the rim.
The contention of the officials, it was halfway down when it was swatted out. So that's actually a two-point field goal. Our score should read 36-14, and it does. And there's a trip up inside before Hamilton could get the ball. If that's on Esho, that's his second. It is.
And that can be one of the positive developments here for the Saigon Heat, as the number one scorer of the Knights picks up his second personal. But again, Darrell Watkins re-enters here in the second quarter with about 8 and 20, 21 remaining. Good minutes, good quality minutes coming from Nugroho.
And the lead is 22 now for the BTN CLS Knights. Hamilton tries one from deep, and they are 1 for 7,000 from beyond the arc right now.
And that's another long shot from somebody who you do not really rely on for outside shooting.
Three-pointer. Oh! Pulling out of bounds! Doug Herring again!
And that's what you call a six-point swing. Low percentage shot on one end from Hamilton, and then a high percentage shot when you talk about Doug Herring hitting that triple from the corner.
25-point lead now for the BTN CLS Knights, 39-14. D'Angelo Hamilton gets away and gets continuation. Three-point play coming up for Hamilton.
That's a better decision there on the part of Hamilton, drawing Darrell Watkins out, taking it strong, getting the foul as well.
And there's going to be a timeout called. With 7:37 remaining in the second quarter, it has been all BTN CLS Knights so far, 39-16. We'll step away, back in a moment. Time down to 7:37 remaining here in the second quarter. This capacity crowd here at the Gorkerta Jaya Gymnasium in Surabaya, Indonesia, getting treated to a spectacular display of basketball from the BTN CLS Knights, leading 39-16 against the Saigon Heat in game one of this best of three quarterfinal series in the ninth season of the ASEAN Basketball League.
Well, if you're the Saigon Heat, Noel, there's nothing you can do about hot shooting except stay on your man and try to challenge. Doug Herring is 4 out of 4 from long distance. You cannot expect him to keep on shooting at this type of a clip. So you just have to stay on him and try to challenge those shots and hope that they start missing. But on your end of the floor, on your offensive end, you have to keep executing and you have to take better shots if you're the Saigon Heat.
Zandy Korniawan dragging down his own miss. And Maxi Esho continues the hot streak.
4 out of 6 from the three-point line for Maxi Esho as a team. Right now, they are 9 of 11 from downtown.
They're 8 points away from the half-century mark. We still have over 7 minutes to go in the first half. Tran with the answer.
That's a good answer there on the part of Quatran, but they're going to have to make stops on their end of the floor.
Lead is 22 for the BTN CLS Knights. Oh, they're going to call this an illegal pick on Febrio Tumo. I'm not sure about this one either.
Manitoma's got to be careful there.
Still having words with our officials.
But you know, so far Otomo with 5 points in the game has played quality minutes, only averages about 2 points per game. And in a playoff match,
right,
he's really giving Wong Wei Long a lot of time to rest and be fresh off the bench.
We're gonna see this one again. Oh yeah, he might. Oh, no, seeing it from that angle, the referees called it right this time.
That's a good call there on the part of the referee, because Otomo really looked for Trevon Hughes and really stopped and put that behind out.
The length of Daryl Watkins forcing this turnover. Febrio Tumo. He has to be erased by Hamilton and had to go through two people. That's how aggressive he's been off the bench.
But you know, that's his role there on the BTN CLS Knights. Whenever he gets minutes, he just has to be aggressive and really try to make an impact. And so far, what an impact he has made here in the first half.
Febrio Tumo, one of the veterans of this squad as well, was here last year. And he's going to have the ball once again against Tran. Entry pass, poked away. And another three by Santi Korniawan. 0-for-2, one of the best shooters in Indonesia.
Has really not gotten his game going, his outside shooting going here in the second half of the season.
Here's Trevon Hughes, still can't buy one. And it is saved Hughes, oh. Yeah, just coming out of bounds and not reestablishing position was Chris Durker that time. Turnover against the Heat.
And Trevon Hughes so far 0 out of 4 from the field. He has not shown a lot of confidence in his stroke.
In stark contrast to the last time Trevon Hughes was in this building, he was almost one of the heroes for the Saigon Heat.
In the last game, Trevon Hughes had 20 points on 7 of 13 from the field. And a really good duel between him and Doug Herring. But so far, it's been all Doug Herring here in the first half.
Doug Herring can't miss. And Trevon Hughes can't hit. That trend has got to change for Saigon soon. Hard show for Barone. Korniawan, bad pass. Here comes Tran. It's a 1-on-3. Tran attacks the defense. Not a good idea. And it stays with the Knights. Here comes Korniawan in transition. And Herring's going to stop. Pop. His first miss from deep. Korniawan tries to keep it alive. And Sandy does keep it alive.
That's a heat check there for Doug Herring. But how about the effort there for Sandy Korniawan? Not able to contribute in terms of outside shooting, but contributing by getting second chance opportunities for his squad.
And Wong Wei Long says, you brought us here, buddy. It's our turn. Back on the floor, the veteran. Former local MVP of the ASEAN Basketball League when he was still playing with the Singapore Slingers. And I still say that with our new rules today, I think Wong Wei Long is the first local to play on two different teams.
And what a big addition he has been here for the BTN CLS Knights, losing Mario Woisang to retirement.
Yeah.
But then coming up with Wong Wei Long, he's only a two-time local MVP.
But the thing is, Wong Wei Long, with the acquisition of Doug Herring, had actually volunteered to play off the ball. Yeah. And Doug Herring now the point guard. That has been actually a stroke of genius for Coach Brian Ralsom.
It's allowed Wong Wei Long to really hang out on the perimeter, especially on those corners where he has been so deadly.
Look at this, Herring on the post up. Great defense, however, by the Heat. And they forced the turnover. Here goes Trevon Hughes. His best opportunity to score is right here, and he does. Oh, and we have an injured player now for CLS.
That was a bad fall there on the part of Otomo, but Otomo sacrificing his body to try to defend that attempt by Trevon Hughes.
Looks like one of the members of the audience also got shaken up. I'll make that, looks like Tran got shaken up, so he's being helped up. There's an unsportsmanlike foul whistle here, Marco. Not quite sure on who, though.
I think that was away from the ball, but so far the guy...
Wow, Fabry's down.
He's in pain, falling awkwardly after challenging that layup by Hughes.
Let's see if we caught that on the replay. Fabry Otomo has played great minutes off the bench in this one, coming up with 6 points so far.
And he's also been perfect from the field, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah. Well, he has to be replaced in this game. Let's see if he can walk off on his own power. Crowd applauds the moment he stands up. And look at this, Darryl Watkins lifting him like he was a sack of rice.
Single-handedly lifting Fabry Otomo.
Well, let's see if he can come back in the game. I'm not quite sure if that was just like knee-to-knee contact or his knee came into contact with the board. Sometimes that's temporary. Let's see this one again. They only have this angle so far. So there's the collision. It was a mid-air collision, actually, Marco. He did not make contact with one of our A-boards. And Tran also going down on the ricochet. That's when the CN Sportsmanlike fouls. Yeah. Whistled, but actually it went against, yes, against the CLS Knights.
I think it went against Brandon Jawato. As Tran tried to make that steal or make that interception, Jawato got called for pulling Tran down.
So Tran with the usual shimmy before the free throws, which irks the crowd here at the Corker at the Giants Gymnasium, and probably everywhere he goes.
4 points in the game for Quatran. There it is. Sort of a Kevin Durant type of shimmy, yeah. But a little more exaggerated.
Yeah, one of the players that gets away with a lot of flair here in the ASEAN Basketball League. But when he plays at home, they love it. Now Tran, more patient offense now being shown by the Heat. Only down 18 after being down 25 just a few moments ago. Three-pointer, Hughes. And Hughes again forced into a bad shot.
Again, one out of six from the field is Trevon Hughes. And you'd probably think that he'd be better off trying to attack the basket, get a ball screen, and try to attack the basket.
How about Maxi Esho attacking the basket that time, and Watkins touches it last.
That's a good box out there on the part of Justin Young, forcing that deflection coming from Darryl Watkins. Another chance here for the Heat to try to trim this deficit down even further.
4:36 remaining here in the second, 42-24 in favor of the BTN CLS Knights. Ball screen provided. And here is Barone. Barone lost the ball. You know, sometimes you can't see through that mask, and that becomes a problem for Kyle Barone.
That's going to be turnover number 8 here for the Saigon Heat.
And Jawato hemmed in, gets it out. Esho, leisurely three, has not made one here in the second quarter after hitting three in the first. Hughes on the attack. Inside out dribble, still can't lose Doug Herring. Hughes bothered that time by Herring.
That's another outside shot there on the part of Trevon Hughes.
Young with a recovery. They will do this again. Tran stepped on the sideline. That's an unforced turnover now against the Saigon Heat.
And you know, those unforced turnovers are going to hurt you long term, because they, instead of allowing you to get momentum, be able to get baskets and trim this deficit even down even further, they just gives the ball back to the CLS Knights.
And the Knights have not really shot the ball well here in the second quarter, but they are still up by 18, 42-24. We have a timeout. We'll be right back. Back with us here at the Gorkar Tajaya Gymnasium with 3:48 remaining in the second quarter. It is 42 for the home team, the BTN CLS Knights, and 24 for the Saigon Heat. Noel Zarate alongside Marco Benitez. And again, this is only the second game of the playoffs, but look at what we have here. A capacity crowd inside the Gorkar Tajaya Gymnasium. They brought their fans. It's a little stuffy up there in the stands, but they are here to support their Knights, and their Knights have been soaking it in.
Yeah, they've not disappointed as they've outscored their opponent, the Saigon Heat, 42-24 here in the first half. Although they've scored, scoring has slowed down here in the second quarter. The Heat have not been able to take advantage.
Only 11 points scored so far by the BTN CLS Knights here in the second quarter after hitting 31 in the first. Three-pointer on its way, and that one is still a miss. Boy, the Heat are struggling from the outside. Like, what, 1 for 9 at this point?
And you know what the Knights are doing is they are forcing the less likely guys to make those outside shots as the ones to take it. That time, Durker, another three-point attempt. Not the guy you'd be wanting to take those.
And long way long, finding Watkins. And Watkins has struggled after making his first basket in this game. Tran, looking to attack the defense, pulls back with under 3 to go.
And they've got a mismatch there with Barón on Herring.
But a great help coming from Maxi Esho, forcing yet another turnover against the Saigon Heat. Herring directing traffic now. Hamilton comes out to meet him. On the post up now, Esho working on Young. And the fall away does not work.
That's a tough shot there on the part of Maxi Esho. One-footed turnaround, fall away. Chance for the Heat here to execute and get a good shot at them.
Now, if the Heat could get this down to like a 12-point deficit by the half, he'd be within striking distance. Oh, nice backdoor cut, and there is Hamilton with a slam.
That's a laser-like pass there on the part of Kyle Barón. And you're going to have to rely on D'Angelo Hamilton and Kyle Barón to give your scoring, as Trayvon Hughes is on the bench right now, still scoreless in the game.
He's actually got two points on the layup, yeah. Here's Esho. And Hamilton now extending his defense. And Esho lost the ball. So with a minute and 52 remaining here in the second, the Heat have it down to 16, Marco, from a high of 25.
Believe it or not, Noel, D'Angelo Hamilton is the leading scorer for the Saigon Heat so far with 7 points. Mm-hmm. Kyle Barón only with 4 points. Trayvon Hughes has 2 points.
It reminds us again of that first meeting where Kyle Barón started off very well in the first quarter. All of Kyle Barón's points have come in the first. So still nothing here, but he is on the floor looking for Hamilton. Tran for three. It is down to 13.
Only the third triple of the game for the Saigon Heat, but slowly but surely they're cutting into this deficit of theirs.
Can't rest on your laurels after building a 25-point lead. Three-pointer out of Hidayat in the game for the first time. And Tran touched it last with a minute and 17 remaining in the first half.
And you see Coach Kyle Julius egging on his team. Those long attempts, those are the types of shots that you want to give the BTN CLS Knights outside of Doug Herring and Maxi Esho.
Barón getting into the passing lanes that time. Shot clock at 13. So again, for the BTN CLS Knights, they can't be complacent at any point of this game, Marco.
And a stop here for the Heat, a basket or a conversion on the other end. If they can trim it down to 11 or 10 points, they're going to go back to that halftime locker room with a bit of the momentum going into the second half.
And remember that Trayvon Hughes is on the bench watching this onslaught or this manslaughter happen. So he'll be pumped up in the second half. Watkins steps back and shoots a three. Not exactly what you want to see if you're Brian Rousham.
That's another good stop for the Saigon Heat. So that's about three possessions where they've been able to get stops. And if they can execute on their end of the floor, trim it down to 11, they're going to have another shot at this to trim it down to single digits going into the half.
Well, there's another kid who hasn't really done much today, Brandon Jawato. We haven't mentioned his name a lot.
Only with 3 points, has only had one field goal attempt so far.
That was that three-pointer earlier. Oh.
That's going to be a turnover. So turnovers continue to hurt the Saigon Heat. That's turnover number 11.
Kyle Julius is shaking his head, but he knows he's got the team within striking distance now. 40 seconds to go in the first half.
You see this matchup. You have Durker on Doug Herring.
And he forces Herring into a tough shot. It'll stay with the Knights.
That's a lucky break there on the part of CLS Knights, because that was a forced shot there on the part of Doug Herring. They have 8 seconds left on the shot clock.
So 31.2 remaining here in the first half. Boy, the Knights are stuck at 11 points after getting 31 in the first quarter.
They've been outscored 15 to 11 here in the second.
Jawato inbounding it to Wong Wei Long. Wong Wei Long, contested jumper. If anything, Tran has played great defense on the guards. Oh, Tran! trying to use some tricks.
Getting a little fancy there is Quatran.
They swing it around, long way long for three, good!
And how big was that miss on one end of the floor from Quatran? Could have shifted momentum to their end. Instead, long way long hits a triple, brings momentum back to the home squad.
Quatran comes up short with a buzzer beater. So instead of having a 13-point lead to contend with heading into the final 20 minutes, it is 45-29. The CLS Knights have regained some form of momentum heading into the halftime break against the Saigon Heat. We'll be back for more action from the playoffs of the ninth season of the ASEAN Basketball League.
Like they used to, they don't make them beats. They don't get their life like they used to, they don't get their life. They don't take the night like they used to, they don't take the night like they used to. They don't snap that snap like they used to, they don't slap that snap. They don't click, they clap like they used to, they don't click, they clap. They don't flash that back like they used to, they don't flash that back. They don't bump that track like they used to, they don't bump that track like they used to.
Dance till the night dies, till the night dies, live. To the sunrise, to the sunrise, work. Get your whole life, get your whole life. We gon' pose for that spotlight. We gon' dance till the night dies.
They don't make them beats like they used to. They don't make them beats. They don't make them beats like they used to. They don't make them beats. They don't get their life like they used to. They don't get their life. They don't take the night like they used to. They don't take the night like they used to.
This shit, I bitch, shit, I boss. One, bitches that are done. Man, yeah, me no make a run. Boy, down, come. Struck you where I get down. Flesh mates follow the tongue.
Shake that one. Thing, miss. Can I shake that?
Miando, Miando.
Take that one. Thing, miss. Can I shake?
Drop me a line, you fall. Man, then blow you a black light.
Abusada, abusada, mente.
Abusada.
Abraham Damar Gahita, who is the sixth man and champion of the Indonesian local league. I want to say thank you, Abraham, for your time tonight. I have a few questions for you. What are you doing up here in Surabaya? What brings you here tonight?
Watching CLS, of course.
Okay.
You know, I watched last season opener right. from CLS against Formosa Dreamer.
Right.
And the atmosphere of this gym is really different than local league.
Okay.
So I think I need to come back to feel that atmosphere.
Okay. So this is the first time also?
No, it's second time watching ABL. All
right. So what is it about the atmosphere tonight that's just so different from any other venues?
You know, CLS night had the best crowd in I think in ABL. I think in Indonesia and the ABL especially. So I think like the atmosphere, you cannot find it in locally.
Right.
So I think that's yeah.
Well, it's good for you to be here, and I just want to ask you, what do you expect from BTN CLS night tonight?
Of course, as an Indonesian, I really wish that CLS win this playoff and win the chips, of course.
Okay. All right. Well, thank you again, Abraham. Congratulations as champion and sixth man of the year.
Appreciate
I'm
it.
Ardo, and good back to you guys. Have a great, great night.
This is where it all begins. We're partners, you and I. When we're together, we're unstoppable. When we're together, anything is possible. At BTN, we know the power of partnership. A good partner works with you intimately. A good partner knows what you need. A good partner always has your back. The partner for starting your dream family, building your dream home, realizing the dream. It takes courage to begin, but it takes encouragement to keep on going. So go on, dream big. We're with you every step of the way. You have a partner in BTN.
Ketika keadaan tak sesuai harapan.
Stop! Jangan banyak drama. Kenalin, Velas, sahabatmu dalam setiap transaksi Velas. Traveling kini tak perlu repot tukar uang ke money changer. Nikmati dunia tanpa batas bersama Velas. Tanpa provisi, tanpa drama.
Fit me, makan mie, jangan mikir.
Ketika keadaan tak sesuai harapan.
Stop! Jangan banyak drama. Kenalin, Velas, sahabatmu dalam setiap transaksi Velas. Kamu bisa mulai tabungan kamu tanpa khawatir kurs naik turun. Nikmati dunia tanpa batas bersama Velas. Tanpa provisi, tanpa drama.
Jangan pakai mikir. Nih, Fitmi, 40 kalori doang. Bisa gitu.
Fitmi, makan mie, jangan mikir.
Ketika keadaan tak sesuai harapan.
Stop! Jangan banyak drama. Kenalin, Velas, sahabatmu dalam setiap transaksi Velas. Dengan kurs kompetitif, bisnis kamu akan selalu mendapat nilai tukar terbaik. Nikmati dunia tanpa batas bersama Velas. Tanpa provisi, tanpa drama.
This is where it all begins. We're partners, you and I. When we're together, We're unstoppable. When we're together, anything is possible. At BTN, we know the power of partnership. A good partner works with you intimately. A good partner knows what you need. A good partner always has your back. The partner for starting your dream family, building your dream home, realizing the dream. It takes courage to begin, but it takes encouragement to keep on going. So go on, dream big. We're with you every step of the way. You have a partner in BTN.
Both teams have kept their fouls in check, and you can see that they've combined for, what, 10 free throws in the first half among the two of them.
That's right. Not a lot of free throw attempts, just 3 out of 3 for the CLS Knights, while 4 of 7 from the Saigon Heat. So if the Saigon Heat can get can continue to be aggressive, going to the basket, get those fouls, possibly draw a third foul coming from Maxi Esho, force him to sit on the bench for some minutes, and they can definitely mount a comeback here in the third quarter.
Third quarter now underway. Second playoff matchup in the season 9 of the ASEAN Basketball League, and that leads to a turnover again. Doug Herring gets it to go. And Chris Durker will be called for the foul.
And again, those live ball turnovers. Nice steal coming from Maxi Escher, translating into a transition basket plus the foul for Doug Herring.
Doug Herring taking it upon himself right now. I believe he's had most of the points in the paint for the BTN CLS Knights.
Upping his scoring here to 16 points.
And they're going to lament those free throw misses a little later on if the Saigon Heat can catch some fire here in the second half. It is an 18-point lead, highest to 25. Barone getting good position in the post, and that's an easy dunk over Esho.
And those are the looks that you want here. Kyle Barone in the post, one-on-one against Maxi Esho.
Lead back down to 16, long way long, almost beating Tran all the way to the cup. They have to recycle now with Doug Herring.
That's something that we've seen Wong Wei Long do here, especially in that first half. Really tried to attack the paint, draw the defense towards him.
But he did hit a three-pointer in that second quarter. Penetration now. Here's Watkins from 14.
That's going to be big for the confidence of Dallin Watkins. Previously one of six from the field before that shot.
Back up to 18 with just over a minute gone by here in the third.
They're going to try to go to Barone in the post again.
Hamilton facing up, now drives. Hamilton, hang time move, and even D'Angelo Hamilton getting involved now.
That's a nice double clutch move there on the part of D'Angelo Hamilton. And again, attacking the basket, getting high percentage shots.
Jawato has been quiet in this game. Watkins looking for a friend. All avenues to the rim denied. He's going to go cross court now to Wong Wei Long, who attacks once again. Wong Wei Long trying to keep it alive, and he does. Wong Wei Long recycling the offense now to Brandon Jawato. They've got 9 on the shot clock. 3 for Jawato, contested. And that's going to go back to the Saigon Heat.
And that's going to be a good stop here for the Saigon Heat. That's a contested shot for Jawato. If they can hit a 3 here, it's down to 13 once again.
Trayvon Hughes still with a quiet game. Let's see if he explodes here in the second half. Oh, Hamilton lifted his pivot foot. That was pretty obvious.
And you know, after that double ball screen for Trayvon Hughes, probably had an open lane to the basket, and that's not the guy you want to be taking those outside shots from the corner. That's D'Angelo Hamilton on the corner.
Hamilton about 6'8", 6'9". More known as a defensive presence. Of course, big shoes to fill in terms of offense with the loss of Murphy Bernatowski, but that's not what they're looking for with Hamilton.
Yeah, and usually it's that it's Bernatowski on that corner.
And here is Watkins trying to power his way in. Keeps it alive momentarily, lost the handle, and here comes Trayvon Hughes.
Another chance, another opportunity here for the Saigon Heat.
Hughes, pass was a little too early for Kyle Barone, and they lose it again.
That's a good point there, Noel. Little too early. Barone had to take one or two more dribbles. And when you put the ball down, especially if you're a 7-footer, expect the smaller guys to try to strip it away from you.
And they touched it last. Still a 16-point lead for the BTN CLS Knights. Wong Wei Long again
continues to be aggressive, continues to attack the body of Quatron, draws the foul once again, and he's going to head to the free throw stripe.
The Wong Wei Law, almost an automatic free throw shooter, close to 90% this season. Close to 90% this season from the free throw line as we see this one again. Again, Wong Wei Long, over the years, has evolved into more of a spot-up shooter, but he's turning back the hands of time here today, Marco, by attacking the paint with reckless abandon, I might say, against a Tran.
That was just a veteran move there on the part of Wong Wei Long. Did not have a clear advantage. He was side by side with Quatron, but again, using his body, drawing the contact, and then going to the free throw line.
And again, almost automatic for the former two-time local MVP of the ASEAN Basketball League. Lead back up to 18, 51-33, as we come up on 7 minutes to play in the third. Tran. That is turnover number seven.
Yeah. He's trying to thread the needle there. That's a dangerous pass and likely getting it deflected. Another turnover.
Esho straight away. Three is good.
Fifth triple of the game for Maxi Esho. And that is really why those turnovers hurt, because you give the CLS Knights another opportunity to score on their end of the floor.
Well, Trayvon Hughes trying to get creative, but really nothing in the barrel for him so far.
And the lead is back up to 21 points.
And it could be 23. Yes, it is. Maxi Esho again. Timeout, Saigon Heat, 56-33. Knights back up by 23. And they only scored 14 points in the second quarter after picking up 31 in the first. So big improvement here for the CLS Knights. Still a lot of time remaining, though. 6-24 here in the third. And the entire fourth quarter ahead of us.
Coach Kyle Julius trying to call in that timeout to stop the bleeding here.
And away from play. This is number three on Esho.
You like the idea of trying to post up Kyle Barone one-on-one against Maxi Esho. And that's going to be a big development. Third personal foul for Maxi Esho. So let's see. Coach Brian Rosen will probably call him to the bench.
He's still on the floor, and they're still on defense. Trayvon Hughes firing this one up. Trayvon Hughes comes up empty again.
And that's another contested shot there for Trayvon Hughes. So far, he is 1 out of 9.
Here's Herring. Under 6 minutes to play here in the third. Wong Wei Long coming off the weave. Wong Wei Long giving continuation. And he has a three-point play opportunity.
And again, that nice weave play from the top of the key. Herring first option. Wong Wei Long second option. Again, using the body, attacking the body of Trayvon Hughes.
And Trayvon Hughes going to be whistled for his second foul.
Has really been out of sync here in this game as Trayvon Hughes. 1 of 9 from the field, 0 of 4 from long distance. 3 turnovers to his name.
Check that, only the first on Trayvon Hughes, and another three-point play for Wong Wei Long.
So far, this is the biggest lead of the game at 26.
It's 59-33. Heat going now to Hamilton, stripped again by Jawato. Hamilton back to Brandon Jawato for three. Good!
Well, what a time for Brandon Jawato to join the party.
Another timeout called by the Saigon Heat. And it is raining threes here at the Gorkem Tachaya Gymnasium. 62-33 for the BTN CLS Knights. A whopping 29-point lead for the home team. We'll be right back. Crowd getting into it here at the Gorkem Tachaya Gymnasium. Look at this sellout crowd to witness game one of the quarterfinals between their home team, the BTN CLS Knights, against the visiting Saigon Heat. Noel Zanet is still alongside Marco Benitez. Tomorrow we have another pair of quarterfinal matchups. That's going to happen. The number one seeded Formosa Dreamers take on the very dangerous number 8 seed, Mono Vampire, with a new coach as well. And of course, the Singapore Slingers hosting the Macau Black Bears in what is starting to become one of the most bitter rivalries in the league.
Well, the Singapore, you cannot sleep on the Singapore Slingers. You know, the Macau Black Bears, one of the highest scoring teams in the league. And knowing that the Singapore Slingers, they will try to grind out another win. They'll try to keep that ball game in the low scoring vicinity.
Yeah. Oh, That's going to be a foul on Watkins trying to reach in.
But this is something we did not expect here in the first meeting of the playoffs between these two squads, the number four team versus the number five team. One of the most evenly matched series that we're going to see here, but CLS Knights running away with this one.
Trayvon Hughes shooting an open air ball. They get it back, however. Hughes tries again from 12 and knocks it down.
Trayvon Hughes breathing a sigh of relief. Only his fourth point of the game.
Long way long, trying to do some early offense. We'll reset it down to Maxi Esho. 4:47 to go here in the third. Knights 62, Saigon Heat 35. Wong Wei Long. And that is touched last by D'Angelo Hamilton.
And the Heat are continuing to switch that ball screen, putting Kyle Barone on Doug Herring. So that puts Justin Young against to box out against Daryl Watkins, resulting in a deflection. Ball stays with the Knights.
Jawajo on the inbound. And here's Herring. They get it to Jawato. And he is catching fire here in the third. Back-to-back threes for Brendan Jawato.
Perfectly run, pin down screen off the baseline inbound. And good recognition on the who is hot on the floor here. Jawato, as you mentioned, back-to-back threes.
30-point lead for the BTN CLS Knights. Young lost the handle all by himself.
And unforced turnovers hurting the Heat. That's turnover number 17.
Wow. They had 11 at the half. That means they picked up six quickly here in the third as we come up on 4 minutes to go.
Definitely something you cannot do if you are the team trying to climb back from this big hole.
Single coverage now for Watkins. Jawato gets the baseline, trying to dunk it. Good defense that time by Hamilton, and here they come. Hughes, that's going to be a blocking foul called on Doug Herring.
Now, what you cannot do if you're the Saigon Heat is you cannot allow frustration to get the better of you. You have to continue playing defense, continue to get their best opportunity possible.
Well, the crowd favorites, Firman Nugroho, who's actually probably the only member of the CLS Knights who has won a championship here in the ASEAN Basketball League when he was still a member of the Indonesia Warriors.
Yeah, that was back in 2012, if I'm not mistaken.
Here's the hand time move by Hamilton. Good challenge that time by the smaller Doug Herring.
Well, that's what Nugroho does as well for your defense. Puts a body, puts a last line of defense.
Uh-oh, Fairbutt gets away. Partially deflected that time, and Young recovers for the Heat. Time down to almost 3 minutes to go here in the third, 65-35. Another miss coming from Trayvon Hughes and another turnover on Young.
Those quick hands by the CLS Knights, just making those deflections, intercepting that basketball. Nothing going right here for the Saigon Heat.
And they have some subs come in. Tran is back on the floor. And Watkins, I think that Herring, trying to get the crowd into it. Boy, he has been one of the best acquisitions, at least one of the best midseason acquisitions in the league.
I remember how they started out 2-7, and then when Doug Herring entered the picture together with Daryl Watkins, they rattled out seven straight wins.
Wong Wei Long gets it!
And just continuing to be aggressive is Wong Wei Long. He's only one out of three from the three-point line, but he already has 12 points in the game.
Tran, three-pointer. That one is short. Rebound picked up by Esho. And everything falling apart for the Heat here with 2:34 to play in the third.
And you have to just see the big disparity in terms of the quality of the shots that the BTN CLS Knights are getting on their end as compared to what the Heat are getting on their end of the floor.
A long way long, giving an open baseline jumper, big mistake.
And where was Quatron on that sequence?
And another miss by Hughes. Hamilton bodies his way in.
D'Angelo Hamilton, leading scorer here for the Saigon Heat with 13 points. On the other end of the floor, you have three guys in double figures for the home squad.
Still a 32-point lead. Is my math correct? Yes, it is. 32-point lead for the Knights. Hughes passes up on an open transition three. Gets it to Tran, who was challenged.
That just gives you an idea of the amount of confidence or the lack of confidence Trayvon Hughes has on his outside shooting today.
Bad if Hideat made that shot. That would have probably sealed the deal here in the third. Oh, Trayvon Hughes getting creative underneath Firmanugro.
And the Knights are just going to try to slow this one down. They have complete control of this ball game with about a minute and 10 seconds left here in the third quarter.
And a slip by Maxi Esho forced into a held ball. And the possession arrow.
And Esho has to be careful. He has three personal fouls. Smart of him to walk away from that sequence.
And it appears that the Knights will keep the basketball with a minute and seven remaining in the third quarter. 69-39.
But D'Angelo Hamilton there forcing that jump ball. One of the few guys who have continued to put up the effort, and have continued to play here despite the big deficit.
The other guys also getting involved are the mop men, trying to keep this floor as dry as possible. Esho, almost a foul on Durker that time. Esho attracts everybody. Jawato puts it on the floor. Brandon Jawato erased by Kyle Barone, and they throw it away. Durker in the front court. Durker left the ball behind, and here comes Hideat. Ahead to Jawato for an easy one.
And how many times have we seen the Saigon Heat almost with an opportunity to score for it to turn into another basket for the Knights on their end of the floor.
Finding an open man inside. There goes Young. So Justin Young with his first field goal of the game. Under 30 seconds to go here in the third. And Esho, pass was a little too strong for him that time.
A wayward pass there on the part of Brandon Jawato.
Look at this, the Heat with only 39 points. And yeah, this third quarter is about to come to an end, Marco.
Saigon Heat average about 85 points per game. Right now, as you mentioned, only with 39. And put Brian Rossum.
Well, when Mo Cerrone comes in the third quarter, it's a party here at the Gorgatajaya Gymnasium. And Esho's going to take a seat for the final 22.
What a luxury right now for Coach Brian Rossum to be able to empty his bench.
Well, he's going to come back full force in the fourth quarter. We know, we're pretty sure about that. Last shot time here for the Saigon Heat. Trayvon Hughes has actually scored more points in the third than he had the entire first half. Barone for three. Young with a rebound, finding Kyle Barone again. And that's going to end hostilities here in the third. So from what was a 16-point halftime lead, the CLS Knights now we're up by 28 at the end of three, 71-43. Fourth quarter coming up. Stay with us right here on the ASEAN Basketball League.
Kenalin, Velas, sahabatmu dalam setiap transaksi Velas. Traveling kini tak perlu repot tukar uang ke money changer. Uang saku kuliah kamu di luar negeri tak lagi terpotong ini itu. Kamu bisa mulai tabungan kamu tanpa khawatir kurs naik turun. Dan dengan kurs kompetitif, bisnis kamu akan selalu mendapat nilai tukar terbaik. Nikmati dunia tanpa batas bersama Velas.
Jangan mikir. Nih, piknik. Tapi jadi dulu.
Fit me. Makan mie. Jangan mikir.
Ketika keadaan tak sesuai harapan. Stop! Jangan banyak drama. Kenalin Velas, sahabatmu dalam setiap transaksi Velas. Uang saku kuliah kamu di luar negeri tak lagi terpotong ini itu. Nikmati dunia tanpa batas bersama Velas. Tanpa provisi, tanpa drama.
And you know, if you're Coach Kyle Julius, if I'm Coach Kyle Julius, I keep my starters in the game. You force them or you allow them to continue playing hard. Try to trim this deficit as far down as possible. You do not allow the Knights to get this type of a mental edge against you, especially in a very short three-game series or a best-of-three series, especially with you going back home to CIS.
Here is Hughes. Thought about it. And there's going to be Justin Young slamming it down.
You just have to keep plugging, keep getting good shots on the offensive end, keep trying to make stops and slowly try to turn this around, even if you're not able to get a win here, but just get your confidence back, especially in this playoff series.
Pick and roll went awry that time for the BTN CLS Knights. Adif Hidayat, first February, Otomo went down with a knee injury earlier in the second quarter. So it's going to be Hidayat picking up all of the backup point guard minutes from this point on.
Last thing you want if you're Coach Kyle Julius is for your team to head into CIS Arena without any confidence, since they have not yet won against this lineup of the CLS Knights.
Three-pointer not there for Hughes. Barone did not contain it, and they will lose possession again.
Yeah, it has been a frustrating evening here for Kyle Barone, to say the least. Only 8 points, 4 of 9 from the field. Trayvon Hughes, 6 points, 3 of 14.
And that's a turnover, rare one forced there by the Heat. There's a love pass, nicely done. Trayvon Hughes to Kyle Barone.
Yeah, slowly but surely, stringing together some positives are the Saigon Heat.
Remember, in the second quarter, they were able to hold BTN CLS Knights to 14 points, 11 points until that final shot of Doug Herring. And speaking of Herring, here he goes. Fall away, doesn't work. Follow slam! Where did he come from? Darryl Watkins!
What an exclamation point there on the part of Darryl Watkins. No box out whatsoever.
And the first basket in the fourth for the Knights is an emphatic one as Tran gets to manufacture some free throws against Adif Hidayat.
And Quatron taking a page or two out of Wong Wei Long, using that body or attacking the body of Adif Hidayat to draw the foul.
Now you have to remember that Quatron has struggled keeping the ball alive for the Saigon. He was at 7 turnovers so far for this kid.
That's right, 7 turnovers, 2 of 9 from the field for 8 points from Quatron.
And he's missed his first free throw as well. So if there's somebody who's got to have a really short memory for the Saigon Heat, it's Mr. Shimmy himself, missing two this time.
And that just keeps the crowd going even further.
Herring playing with practically no rest in this one. Esho nursing 3 fouls, he's got the ball. Justin Young on him, forcing Esho to pick up his dribble. Hidayat with 6 to shoot. Hidayat, deep 3, hits the board. That's going to be a shot clock violation against the BTN CLS Knights.
That's a good stop there on the part of the Saigon Heat. Let's see if they can get another positive development or another positive opportunity on their end of the floor.
And if you're Brian Rossum, you also want your bench to see as many minutes as they can in this game as well, to try to keep those starters,
that's right,
fresh for game two.
And you know, possibly avoid getting any uncalled for or unforeseen injury,
yeah,
from your starters with this game very much in hand.
7:25 to go. The lead is 26 for the BTN CLS Knights. BTN CLS Knights 73-47, and there's an entry pass fouled before the shot.
And you know, for Coach Brian Rossum, if he can maintain this lead with about 4 or 5 minutes remaining, I would expect him to pull out his starters and give them a rest for the rest of the game.
Just the opposite is happening right now. Wong Wei Long comes back into the game to replace Adif Hidayat.
Maybe for one last run.
Yeah. Well, Sandy Konyawan also back in the game now for the BTN CLS Knights, as they have 6 to shoot. Doug Herring puts it up.
And you know, if there's a guy that you want to set up, want to get his confidence back, it's Sandy Kurniawan,
right,
because he's somebody who you can definitely use if you want to go deep into the playoffs.
Watkins forced out of the post and forced into a bad shot. 3 misses on that trip. for the BTN CLS Knights. Kyle Barone bringing down the ball with 6:42 to play. Tran, Barone, straightaway three, not there. And the rebound again to Watkins.
The three-point shooting has really deserted the Saigon Heat. Just 3 out of 20, so below 15%.
Wow. And Herring, this early, is befriending the clock.
He's milking the clock.
Herring takes it strong, and when he decides to score, very little you can do about it.
And that time doing it against Chris Durker was no pushover.
Tran continues to shoot blanks. Hughes will make that. Oh, Sandy Cornelan cherry picking on the other end there, Marco.
And he will take that basket whichever way he can get it. First 2 points of the game for Sandy Cornelan.
Lead back up to 30. 5:40 to play. Tran getting it to the side, and that's going to be a miss. However, Kyle Barone is there to clean it up.
And Doug Herring just one assist away from a double-double.
Well, he's also come close on those rebounds, Marco. He's for a guard, he's a pretty good rebounder. Maxi Esho on the escape.
And Maxi Esho has gotten pretty much whatever he wants here in the fourth quarter.
Back up to 30, 79-49, and another turnover, but the Heat get it back. Three-pointer on its way. Not really a good shot there coming from Chris Durker.
I believe this is already garbage time here.
Yeah. They're calling this extended garbage time in Indonesia. So what a statement win, or impending win here in game one. Oh.
Would have been assist number 10. It would have been a highlight flush for Daryl Watkins.
And if you're Brian Rosenknight right now, you're looking at all the showtime happening. You know, you got to get everybody now on the same page. Guys, we haven't won anything yet. This is just game one.
Quick timeout here.
It is a timeout by the BTN CLS Knights. 79-49, a 30-point lead here in game one. We'll be right back. But again, Marco, this is just game one of the best of three. The series shifts back to Ho Chi Minh in a couple of days.
And if this is going to be it for the starters of the Saigon Heat, the lesson here is that you forget about your mistakes, just try to learn from them, and then come out fresh. Start 0-0, come out stronger when you get back to CIS. It has been an old-fashioned beat down here for the CLS Knights.
And this all started in the first quarter when the Saigon Heat allowed 31 points from the CLS Knights while only getting 14 themselves. Three-pointer on his way. That's Nguyen, who's seeing his first action of the game.
I believe that was 7 triples in that first quarter where they outscored the Heat 31-14. 27 of those 31 points coming from the perimeter.
Here's Bo Cerrone. He's back in the game. Cerrone on the post up has it poked away. And it's just going to be a matter of time right now as Durker can't finish. And the Heat will be able to get it back.
I remember the CLS Knights had previously won their last two meetings against the Heat by a total of just 3 points.
This is Nguyen Tuan on the turnaround. That's going to be a foul called. Oh, check that. That's going to be an out-of-bounds play.
Well, Coach Brian Rosum still keeping Maxi Esho and Doug Herring. Herring is going to go out in favor of Gemilang, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah. So seeing his first action, that's actually Baskoro. That's Captain Baskoro seeing his first action of the game. So now our struggle begins here, Marco.
Baskoro only averages about 1.25 points per game, has only played in 12 games this season. Esho is still in the game.
And Esho continues to stroke it.
Just to add to his point total, 24 points right now for Maxi Esho, 8 of 17. He is 6 of 10 from long distance.
Chris Durker trying to stay active. And that foul is going to be called on Mo Cerrone. So with 3:22 to go, more of the bench players coming in. And finally, Maxi Esho takes a bow. The last player off the bench is coming in That's Arshanya. Or Arshanya, seeing his first action of the game.
One of the few times Ardiansa has been able to see action.
Yeah, Ardiansa. It's like a burly point guard as well. Chris Durker splits the free throws, and Mosaroni with a rebound. So 82-50. It's only a question of the final score at this point as we come up on 3 minutes remaining in this one.
And you know, Noel, if I'm mistaken, this is the first sign of action Ardiansa has seen this entire season.
Oh, are you kidding me? And that's going to be a foul called on Chris Durker. He's going to send Vascoro to the free throw line.
Yeah, I'm sure Coach Brian Rosen would want nothing better than to get Sandy Kurniawa on some open looks and allow him to hit those any of those triples just to get his confidence going.
Remember the first half of the season, he was averaging almost two three-pointers a game.
That's right. He's really fallen into a slump here in the second half of the regular of the season.
So Katon Baskoro able to split the free throws, upping the lead to 33 right now. And now this brings us to a few scenarios as well. For now, you know, the BTN CLS Knights actually are building a win streak. They have won now four straight since losing to the Singapore Slingers in this building a few weeks ago. But now this puts them in a good position. They're going to take a 1-0 lead in this best of three. San Miguel Ala Pilipinas forced to a do or die against Hong Kong Eastern.
That's going to be a big matchup in South Orange Stadium.
Yeah. Now, of course, tomorrow it's going to be started by that matchup, 1-8. Formosa Dreamers against the Mono Vampire. And a lot of people are saying that the Formosa Dreamers, although they have a pretty elite lineup working for them, that the Mono Vampire could actually give them a lot of problems.
That's correct. Mono Vampire was one of the hottest teams during the latter portion of this season. I believe they had a streak of six straight games, six straight wins as we close out the regular season as Durker gets that bucket.
They wanted an offensive foul call on Chris Durker. Well, you can't have it all at this point. But they will have the most important thing, which is a win in game number one, with the starters watching on the bench with under 2 minutes to go. This was not the case the last time these two teams played.
Yes.
The starters had to bail them out after falling behind by 11 points in the final 2 minutes of the game. And that's also going to be it for Wong Wei Long. But Wong Wei Long has reinvented himself in this game.
Yes.
Or probably not reinvented as a term. He has turned back the hands of time in this game. And how about Brandon Jawato leading the cheers?
Just getting the crowd going here with about 1 minute and with 1 minute and 42 seconds remaining. And as you mentioned, Wong Wei Long has, you know, one of the reasons why he's been able to reinvent himself is because of the presence of Doug Herring. He has not had the burden of having to play that point guard role extensively, talking about Wong Wei Long, because of Doug Herring.
Katon Baskoro is going to need a massage at the end of this game. He is picking up from where Wong Wei Long left off.
And this is one of the most extensive minutes that Katon Baskoro has been able to play here this entire season.
Well, a minute and 38, he's still got a chance to add to his stats. He's got 1 point in this game.
Again, now, talking about the other matchups, Singapore Slingers against the Macau Black Bears. That's number three Singapore at 16-10. Facing the Macau Black Bears, 14-12. Again, the Macau Black Bears losing Anthony Tucker towards the latter portion of the season. That was one of the biggest blows to them.
Well, they did. They were able to get a new import there. And a miss from the outside. That would have brought the house down as well. Three-pointer on its way, Nguyen Thuan. And it's going to be locals on locals.
And just go back and try to review the keys to this ball game. Perimeter scoring in particular for the CLS Knights. We talked about how they were tied for best three-point percentage in the league at about 37%. And actually upping their average here throughout most of the game. 46%, 14 of 30 from long distance. And the Saigon Heat's inability to defend the perimeter was really what caused their downfall early.
There's a three-pointer that's going to drop for the Saigon Heat. That is a win.
Very win, yeah.
On the scoring end there. So the final minute in this one, game decided as early as the first quarter. And I can't think that you can say that about a team in the playoffs where they had a game decided as early as the first quarter.
And you know, we were even talking about how evenly matched up this series was going to be, only to have a blowout as early as halftime.
Either at the head, come on, Sandy.
Crowd cheering Sandy Kuryawan.
Well, he's one of the consummate. He's one of the consummate team players, Marco. He had an open shot, but hey, no rebounders. Let's set it up again. Oh, there's one, Sandy.
Still not able to connect from the outside.
He will be an integral part moving forward, of course, trying to get those three-pointers off the bench as Chris Durker is able to trim the deficit somewhat. With only 16 seconds remaining, Brian Rousham's calling them off already.
You will look at the output of the imports of the Saigon Heat. 13 points for D'Angelo Hamilton, 12 points for Kyle Barone, and he was only able to enter double figures during garbage time. Trayvon Hughes, only 6 points for 3 of 15 from the field.
They have done their job here at home, coming away with an 84-59 victory. The BTN CLS Knights registering their first playoff win in the ASEAN Basketball League. Remember, this team missed the playoffs, and she is praying that they can do it again on the road in Saigon. Otherwise, game three will be back in this building.
What a confidence-boosting win here for the BTN CLS Knights. All smiles for them as they manhandled and had a masterful performance against the visiting Saigon Heat.
Once again, confirmation of our final score, 84-59. We'll be back to wrap things up after these.
All right, and here we are, way back in Goa Kartajaya. I'm here with Coach Brian Rossum and their first win of the series. Sir, looking back at this win, was everything just as you expected from your squad?
Yeah, we played very good defense. We wanted to play defense from the very beginning. Okay. And that was the difference for us tonight.
Okay. In the beginning of the year, you were 0-2, but you went back 2-0 since then, and now you're getting 3-2 for tonight. What did it take to bring the series back between you and Saigon?
Well, you know, they're a very good team, and we match up well with them. They match up well with us also. Okay. So we have to continue to do what we did tonight, play good defense and share the ball on offense.
That's good. So coming into the next game in Ho Chi Minh, this is on April 3rd, what will you be focusing on with your team?
We have to play again the same way because it's going to be a very difficult game for us in Vietnam.
All right. I just want a quick update on Febri, who went down on the first half.
Yes, he's injured right now. He's going to get checked out by the doctors, and hopefully he can play on Wednesday.
Okay.
He was a big help for us tonight.
Coach Brian, congratulations. See you in Ho Chi Minh.
Three Makassar.
All right. That was Coach Brian, and I've got with me a player of the game, Maxi. I hope you're not getting bored with me, man. 24 points. 6 of 9 from 3.
Yeah.
5 rebounds, 4 steals. Like, in spite of that, what really brought the win tonight?
Defense.
That's exactly what Coach Brian was talking about the whole time, defense. So, it took you a while to get heated up around my second quarter, but how do you maintain your focus in spite of taking time for you to heat up in the first half?
I just let the game come to me, not forcing it, knowing that we are playing as a team, that it's a lot of people that can score the ball, you know what I mean? From me, Duado, Doug, even Daryl and Waylong, and even the guys on the bench, we got so many guys that can score the ball.
It's great to have depth on the bench as well.
So it's all about finding the right shots, making the right shots, and Coach preaches that in practice a lot, in defense. So everybody came in a defensive mindset.
That's incredible. You guys all have been thinking about how to hold it on the defensive end.
Yeah.
So consider that by most as a blowout. At which point you feel like the win was pretty much yours tonight?
Five minutes in the fourth quarter. You know what
but
I mean?
But not before that.
No, because they are a team that can always come back.
That's right.
And I know when we go to Saigon, they're gonna be ready for us. So.
Okay. I got one last question. What will you be working on until April 3rd in Ho Chi Minh?
Defense, rest of my body. And shooting the ball, doing the regular things I do.
Okay.
Okay.
Well, congratulations, Maxi Astro, on your second game later on April 3rd.
Thank you, bro.
All right. There you have it. Play of the game, Maxi Astro. We're going to come at you back live here in Goa Kartajaya. My name is Ardo. Back to you guys for more in-depth analysis here at Playoffs ABL.
All right, thank you very much, Ardo. He's also on full playoff mode, by the way. And Maxi Esho, Brian Rousham, the key word that we heard in both interviews, Marco, was the word defense. And holding the Saigon Heat to just 59 points is a testament to that.
Well, they held the Saigon Heat to 16 points or less in each of the four quarters.
Wow.
And that just talks about how much defense they played. And whenever you can beat a team by this much, despite being outscored 40-28, from inside points, that just speaks well and speaks a lot about your perimeter scoring. 14 of 32 from three-point land, holding the Saigon Heat to 4 of 26. Remember, the Saigon Heat, third best in terms of three-point makes per game, at about 9 three-pointers made per game. And you see the assist numbers, 17-14. You force them to 23 turnovers, you score 21 turnover points against the Saigon Heat, and that's pretty much the ball game for the BTN CLS. What a statement game for them in the first matchup of the playoffs.
Now the scene shifts to Ho Chi Minh as we see some of the highlights from the game. Scene shifts to Ho Chi Minh City this coming April 3rd. Not really much of a long rest. Well, Maxi Esho, he said he needs to take care of his body. He really made sure that his body was in tune tonight.
24 points, 6 rebounds, 6 of 10 from the three-point line. And I like what he mentioned. He did not force himself, let the game come to him, because he had a lot of confidence and a lot of trust in his teammates, guys like Doug Herring, Brandon Jawata, Wong Wei Long, to keep them in the game and really to actually even take the lead or grab the lead for them without him having to score.
And on the defensive side, Marco, he came away with 4 steals, yeah, which was a catalyst to one of those 23 turnovers. Now, for the Saigon Heat, of course, they need to have a very short memory as we see the entire clip of Maxi Esho for this game. For the Saigon Heat, they need to have a very short memory because they have a wild crowd also there at CIS at Ho Chi Minh City. Probably, and they will be the first to say this, wilder than what we have here in Indonesia.
Well, I think for the key for the Saigon Heat, number one thing is to start out strong. They cannot afford to start flat-footed, especially on their home floor, if they want to bring momentum back to their end of the floor.
Well, of course, ladies and gentlemen, 84-59 is the final in this one. Game one belonging to the BTN CLS Knights. And tomorrow we do have 2 more playoff matchups that will start with their game one. The Formosa Dreamers taking on the Mono Vampire over there in Taipei. And of course, the matchup between the Singapore Slingers and the Macau Black Bears in Singapore. And that's all the time we have for you here at Gor Kertajaya Gymnasium here in Surabaya, Indonesia. For Marco Benitez, my name is Noel Zarate, and you have been watching the 9th season of the ASEAN Basketball League as we continue to rise to greatness here in the playoffs. The Knights taking game one, 84-59.
This is where it all begins. The leap of faith. The first step to the journey. Towards the unknown. The challenging. The daunting. But when we're together. Hand in hand. The journey becomes exciting. We're partners, you and I, together, facing your fears, pursuing your passion, breaking boundaries, building your future, overcoming challenges, celebrating every achievement. When we're together, we're unstoppable. When we're together, anything is possible. At BTN, we know the power of partnership. A good partner works with you intimately. A good partner knows what you need. A good partner always has your back. A partner for starting your dream family, building your dream home, realizing the dream. It takes courage to begin, but it takes encouragement to keep on going. So go on, dream big. We're with you every step of the way. You have a partner in BTN.